Well, I'm back in the workshop, just finishing off a couple of things before I next get out and camp. One thing is just putting this stainless steel topper on like the food preparation section of the drawer system. I was gonna go with aluminium, but somebody in the comments section recommended stainless steel, and I thought, yeah, that's actually really smart. So thanks for that, and should be easier to clean. Things that are easy to clean are... But that is the drawer system pretty much finished. I actually had to remove the whole thing to build an electronic setup. It's something I'm working on at the moment. Haven't really made a video on it because we've got the parents-in-law here and I've been a bit strapped for time. And also I'm shit with electronics, so if I made a video, it would be like what not to do or watch a guy learn to do something for the first time. So I haven't really bothered, but I can show you the setup. I'm going to go into handheld mode because it's just a bit easier. But you remember there was a couple of ports here. I've just got all the wiring in place. And there's lots of nice screws firing through that gull wing, which will eventually be bolts. It's just I'm setting it up. But this used to be tools, this gull wing box. That one is still recovery kit. And the tools have now moved under the seats because it's just way safer, I guess. But I want to use this gull wing for electronics. So that's kind of what I'm putting in here at the moment. So I've got an Orion smart charger there and an MPPT, just a little one. And I'm kind of in the process of getting it wired up, really, so I can kind of show you this, but this will be a pretty crap video. Some bus terminals just arrived, so I'm going to need a few of those for all the positives to kind of be somewhere and all the negatives to be somewhere. I probably will remove that earth and put this bus terminal there or something, but I'm still waiting for like a fuse box, a switch panel that will go in there. So, you know, all the switches will be here. So you'll have like compressor, lights, inflatable doll, Black Mamba charging station, and all the kind of shit that you really need on an overland trip there, like Bigfoot bear spray, I don't know, just whatever. But, you know, just so there's going to be some switches anyway, and I've got the lights to put in there, but, you know, I haven't done that bit yet because it's summer and it's 24-hour daylight. And that's just how we roll here, get lazy. But under the seats is where the battery positioning is going to be. And I got this idea off another video of someone who put these here and used them for like batteries for speakers. But I basically went online and found... I'm going to go back to AMG anyway before I get started on why I'm doing this. They're 90 amp hour. I'm going to have two of them. I've just got one at the moment. It's quite an expensive battery because it's like an AMG gel battery. And this battery can be mounted on its side or even standing on this end here upright if you wanted it to. But I've just got it mounted this way because on its side, the corner makes it really uncomfortable to sit down. Whether it's flat like that, you still have a few inches of foam, but you actually have like a flat surface you're sat on. So it's actually a pretty comfortable seat still. But the foam doesn't go all the way to the bottom. That's just there because, I don't know, I thought it looked better. But the battery boxes are floating. So you can kind of see under the battery box, if it focuses, that they're floating. And the reason being is originally I was going to cut all this out and modify everything and have the battery a bit lower down. But you lose so much of the seat material that the structure of the seat begins to kind of falter and it just doesn't feel very good. So having a floating battery box seems to work really well, and it means that when the water pools under here, because it always seems to kind of get in there somehow, it can kind of, you know, evaporate without being sandwiched. Originally I started to cut under the floor pan, you know, to try and, you know, basically like seat the battery box under the vehicle so it was hanging down. And then the seat could have been left intact, but the frame of the vehicle's right there, and you'd have to cut through the frame or have a really small battery that was like this big instead of like this big, and then it just becomes a problem. But I'll just go around the other side.
You might be a bit hesitant to try this out, and it really depends like how much you think people sit at the back. Now, if you're building an overland vehicle where you're just losing the rear seats and just making this one big drawer system, like, you know, this is a no-brainer, isn't it? You can do whatever the hell you want. But in my case, you know, I've got one child, another one's on the way. So, you know, we've got two boys, and me and my wife, and we do like to go out and use this vehicle. Now, people have said get a van, but, you know, I don't have the time nor the money to get a van and build one up. So the Cherokee is what we've got. We've got two Cherokees, and one will probably be sort of built up in a more kind of classic sense, the 4 litre. And this one is just going to be my like sort of overlandy kind of vehicle, but it's pretty comfortable to sit on. Obviously sitting in the middle, it just feels like a regular squishy seat. It's a bit firmer here, but it's definitely not uncomfortable. Like, it's not uncomfortable at all. It's not even as firm as like a stool, for example, with a cushion on it. It's softer than that. So the idea is that I'll be using these connectors here and this kind of thing. So I'll just convert everything over. And at the back of the refrigerator, hopefully you can see this, but I'm just going to have this little sort of box here, sort of tucked in there at the back. On top of the drawer system, it's going to have a couple of ports in. One can be used from the fridge, and the other's going to be used for the compressor.
The compressor is mounted just in here, and so it's going to plug in at the back there. I'm going to have them wired in so those ports are on switches. So even though the compressor and the fridge aren't permanently wired in to the electronic system, the ports themselves are going to be on switches. So, you know, the appliance, for example, can always be on, although the fridge not so much, but the power on button's there. So it's not so much of a hassle. The compressor button's down there. But these are changeable things. You know, the compressor might break. I might change it. I might get an ARB one. I might mount something in here like later when I like what I'm using. And the fridge is kind of small. It's 15 litres or 14 actually. And basically, you know, I built the platform to support a bigger fridge, you know, something like a 35 litre. Because although summer here is short in the north, you know, you need this to keep things like gas bottles and all sorts of stuff warm in the winter, where you want an insulated box to stop things freezing.
So these units can get pretty hot, and they lose efficiency as they get hot. And this is a sealed box, you know, so it's not the smartest flipping design really, in my behalf. But you know, it does keep all the electronics just tucked away and the vehicle nice and neat. And if you need to change a fuse or you need to do anything, you just open the hatch and you get on with it, you know, and you're there, and it's all in one place. So to have this all in the back of the Jeep somewhere else, less accessible, I don't think would have been ideal. But, you know, somebody suggested, or a friend of mine suggested, putting like vents on the outer side of the gullwing. So like you have a vent here that's slightly open, like a hood louver or a hood vent, and another one there. So as you're driving, the air's going in and getting forced out there. Because really it's only when you're driving that that unit is going to be going wild. And whilst you're stationary, that one probably won't generate quite as much heat because it's quite small. A lot of people are using fans, but my issue being is fans are pretty loud, you know. The problem is, if that fan's making that racket as I'm driving along, people are going to hear it from outside the vehicle and think that I'm basically trying to get myself off with a vacuum cleaner whilst driving my Cherokee. But in all seriousness, it's making a lot of noise, isn't it? And I don't think people are going to appreciate, like, my son sat at the back there with that thing making all that noise next to his head. It's just not great. So yeah, maybe I can put it on a resistor and make it run slower, just so it circulates. So I don't know about this shit. Maybe you can help me out. I like the idea of the hood louver thing, so the air's getting forced in and getting pushed out, because it's really only going to be generating heat when you're driving, isn't it? So yeah, we'll see. So that was probably an extremely boring shit video, but you're not going to see me next Sunday. We've got people here this week, and I've got some people coming next week as well, some friends from the UK staying with us for sort of 5 days. So I probably won't have time to film anything, unless my mate who's coming is up for doing a walk around of his Navara. He's got a Navara and he's just done an M57 swap on it. Then you will see a video potentially next Sunday, but it's just whether or not he's up for doing it. I don't like to push people, you know, with films and stuff, and you know, it's good to like not film everything you do, or else it just ends up ruining it for you. But anyway, a lot of people have asked about the 4.0 Renix and whether I've forgotten it. I absolutely have not. and I have been working on it and I have been filming it. I just haven't done enough to really put together a video on it, and on the back shelf there I've got lots of parts for it. I'm just one of these people who finds it really difficult to move from one project to another without finishing a job. Like, I'm one of these guys, I like finish a job, move on to the next job. So and that might not make sense, because the 4 liter I started a while ago and then I went back on this vehicle, but the point being is when I got started on the 4 liter, it was to see whether it was worth working on, you know, get the engine running nice, check the transmission, the MP231, the Fördelings loader, speaking Swedish now, the transfer case, the axles, all that kind of stuff, you know, oil changes, just make sure it was a viable project to actually put time and money into. And I know it is now, because it's driving and I've been out in it and it works great. So that's kind of like why I then parked it up and got back on this again with the draw system, because the draw system, the electronics on this are really the final touches to kind of like it being a complete kind of overland traveling vehicle, you know, and it's something I've wanted to do for a long time. So it's really on the cards to be on the channel very soon, the 4 liter. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you found this video useful or inspirational or something, or just boring as fuck and it helped you fall asleep. Take care. I'll see you again in another one.